Hi, we're Dashboard Confessional, and this song is called Stolen. Hey, we're Dashboard Confessional. This song is called Rooftops and Invitations.
Curves, you were hooked, and the glances you took hold of you and demanded that you stay. Sunk in their teeth, bit you hard and and released. Such a charge that you need another touch, another taste, another fix. She just might get you lost, and she just might leave you torn, and she just might save yourself if she gets you and she gets you any closer. Skylines and stars, steeple chases and bars, and took your keys and demanded that you stay. City long 12-4, rooftops and invitations, all ace in secret places. She moves you to touch with her hands. She just might get you lost, and she just skin and skin will meet out on the inside, where the girl's prize is at the tip of your tongue, where every move and each impulse brings clarity to stay. She just might get you lost, and she just might leave you torn, she just might save your soul if she gets you any closer. She just might. And she just might leave.
You know, on all my records, I've been pretty open. I've been willing to write what I feel. And on this, and I always think that, you know, I've done that, and maybe I'll move to something, some kind of different kind of attitude or cornerstone for song, for the new songs as things go on. I keep finding that there's no shortage of life experience to write about. So I really felt myself close off for a little while. I wrote songs and I just really felt disconnected from them. And then somewhere along the line, everything just sort of opened up, and I really felt like I placed myself in these songs, and then the next thing you know, I was swept up in them. And the first song that I wrote for the record is a song called So Long, So Long. And I wrote it, it's a piano song, it's kind of a sort of commentary on how it always feels to be leaving, and sometimes it feels great to leave, sometimes it doesn't feel so great to leave. And by leaving, I mean like my hometown, my little beach town that I'm from. I'd written it quite a while before I wrote everything else for the record. By the time I'd written everything for the record, I'd cast this song off, and somehow, sort of at the 11th hour, it was always in my head, it was sort of always in my heart. In my heart of hearts, I knew it should be on the record. I don't really know why I veered away from it in the first place, why I became disinterested in it. It's funny, it is almost a bit like it's the centerpiece of the record, because it's delicate and powerful, it has its moments of each, so it really ties the whole record together. And until I had it recorded, the record really didn't feel like it was a record. I think my first musical memory is probably my mom playing the Beach Boys in the car. That's kind of my earliest, like when I was like, whoa, like the melodies and the harmonies just, they sunk their teeth into me, and I couldn't get enough of it. My mom was a singer. I think she recognized my interest because she had it herself. She is a singer, she's a great singer. And so she started singing the parts and try this part, and we'd be singing harmonies in the car and stuff. It's a pretty cool way to learn how to put music together. It was really fun. Yeah, that's probably my earliest musical memory. The first record I can remember buying, I think I might have purchased one before, but I know I bought a Purple Rain 45. That's kind of my first real memory of walking by myself to go get a record. I don't even know why I picked that record. Who knows why? I certainly wasn't allowed to see the movie as a kid, but. And then I bought Toto and Billy Joel record. And then one of my cousins gave me a Beatles record, and that was pretty wild, and a Stones record. I kind of stopped listening to Toto after that. Big influences for me are definitely Bob Dylan, Elvis Costello. The Beach Boys are a big influence for me about melody. And then there's bands like Jawbox and Jawbreaker that really lit me on fire when I was young. And REM, I remember when I got when I bought Document, and I was like, well, I've got to learn how to play guitar. So that was those are some big ones for me. I can remember the first time I heard kids sing along, and it was like the first show, because the kids were just my friends, and one of my friends had dubbed the record I'd made, the five song record I made, and given it to everybody, and they'd learned it unbeknownst to me, and they just started singing. Well, I really don't know how that spread into all this, but that was the first time I can remember it. But I remember the first time that I was like absolutely shocked was probably, you know, the first time I left Florida. I mean, Florida's a pretty big state, but for word to spread so far north from where I live so far in the southeast, in Florida alone, I mean, that was a big deal. But I remember when I got up and played Georgia for the first time, and these kids were singing at the top of their lungs, and they knew every word, and we didn't have a record. And I thought to myself, something strange is going on here. It's kind of been that kind of way ever since. on tour with you two. I'd gotten off stage and I had this really great feeling about playing and about this. You know, you get this feeling when you're playing live in any setting, and it's really hard to pinpoint. And it's like you're filled with helium or something like that. It's like you just. It's like you're all your senses are heightened and you're in such a state that you can think so clearly. And I remember walking off stage being like, man, I really want to play more songs. And I really just had this feeling like I want to stay in this moment. So I just went in the locker room and I let that moment kind of lead me into writing. And I wrote all the way. I mean, they played, I didn't see a note of theirs that night because I played, and when they were done, I mean, the place was emptying out, and somebody came in and was like, hey, we gotta go, what are you doing? And I'd been writing the whole time. But the funny thing was I'd written it in like 5 minutes, but I was so into it, I just kept playing it and playing it, playing it over and over and over. 5 minutes might be a little short, maybe 10 minutes. But anyway, I just kept playing it for hours. And it was kind of, it's prophetic because I took that feeling of that live show and I put it into this song, and it led me into this song. And then now when I play that song live, I mean, it's like, it kickstarts the whole room. And I mean, it puts us right in that place, you know, where we, instantaneously, there's no like crawl to get there. There's no slow and steady. It's just like, you're there. Yeah, I'm continually surprised at our success. I don't know so much why we've been embraced so wholeheartedly by our audience, but it really is like a grassroots thing, and they really are so dedicated to us. And in turn, we're really dedicated to them. We'll go to great lengths to make sure that they're happy. That's why we spend so much energy developing our live show and being so particular. I mean, I don't know who isn't surprised at their success. I mean, even guys that play it off like they're supposed to be there, they still gotta be stoked, right? So, I don't know, I just kind of count my blessings and kind of enjoy the ride. When I believe in a song, I start playing it. And it's not to see how anybody else feels about it. It's just that I'm ready to do it. And I think that was the case. You know, I didn't do too many of them because I didn't know how I felt yet. But when the records started to come together, I started playing out songs like Don't Wait. That one I played the very first day I wrote it, I played it at a show, at a fundraiser that I had put together for a Katrina benefit. And it was like a really long song because I hadn't settled on what I wanted to say, so I just said it all. I wasn't sure what the song was really about, so I made it about everything. And you know, it's cool. There's, you know, it's floating around on the internet. That very first day, the first day I wrote it, there's a version of it that's been recorded and is out there. It's fun. It's fun to do it that way. Some of them I held really close to the chest, and there's even ones I've played here for you at Target that I haven't at this point yet played for anybody else. So you're the first.